before I take on Phoenix's hottest wings in baseball, I'm getting a scouting report at the Diamondbacks' Chase Field. Andrew, talk to me. I got to take on this challenge, and it's the hottest wings in baseball. It's 8 ghost chili and habanero drenched wings, and I got to eat them in 6 minutes. So you have any advice for me?
It's all in your head. I mean, they say the game's 90% mental and the other half's physical.
90% mental, and then 10% I'll worry about that after I'm done.
Right, yeah. You can go cry all you need to after that.
Strike 3, you're out.
So, Patrick, you're used to throwing the heat. So how does a guy take the heat?
I just try to go as quick as I can, get it over with.
Get
That's
over.
What I would do.
Quick, go fast.
Yeah.
I think in this case, about winning the inch. An inch means a play that's made because you prepared for it. I think you might be ready and prepared right now. That's my gut feel.
Yeah.
Because I think you've already
had... It's funny you said gut. That's where it's all going to go. Yeah, Thank man. You so much.
Good luck.
Yeah, I'm going to need it.
Dink.
I can't delay any longer. It's my turn at bat to try to knock the hottest wings in baseball out of the park at Game 7 Grill. If I could strike out 8 ghost pepper and habanero-soaked wings in 6 minutes, I'll join the mere 12% who have knocked it out of the park. The mighty Casey is at the plate. Game 7 Grill is a pure home run. Sitting next to the Diamondbacks' Chase Field, they're serving up elevated ballpark classics from the mesquite smoked chicken nachos to the barbecue pulled pork tacos. And of course, the million-plus Scoville unit ghost pepper and habanero-drenched wings. The hottest wings in baseball challenge. It's 8 wings in 6 minutes, and they're drenched in ghost chili and habanero sauce. Just trying to get some advice.
Just don't stop.
Don't stop. I can't stop. I only got 6 minutes.
Just be aggressive. Just react.
Be aggressive or react. Yes! You're going down, hottest wings in baseball, because he said so. I'm about to face one of the hardest challenges that I've ever had to take on.
It's going to be hot. Not like the temperature hot here in Arizona, because that's about 100. You're about to hit 200 plus. These are ghost peppers we're talking about.
Ghost and habanero.
Yeah. Focus on the finish line is what I'm telling
Focus
you.
Focus on the finish line.
And when you succeed, you remember the guys who helped you get there.
Failed.
If you fail, you did it on your own.
It's time to take a swing at creating the hottest wings in baseball.
Hey, Steve, how are you, bud?
Hey, good to see you.
Thanks for having me back here. So this is the den of hell.
Pretty much.
And you just confirmed that with that little laugh. So how hot is it? Talk to me.
It's wicked hot. It's that kind of blazing heat that kind of it hits you right away. Because we have a certain heat level that we want it to be at.
And right, you can't get that naturally.
Habaneros can come in at 150,000 units or 375. The ghost chilies can range from 800,000 to 1.1 million. The extract that we use is 1.5 million.
You're crazy. How many people have actually taken it up?
So hundreds have tried it, and we've only had about 10 complete it since 2013.
Those numbers are bad. All right, so let's build this fiery beast.
We're going to start with the base. Cayenne pepper sauce.
That's just cayenne pepper.
Yeah, cayenne vinegar.
Can I try a little bit?
A little spicy, okay?
Oh, yeah, it's great.
So dried ghost pepper.
Yes, dried ghost chilies tend to be a little bit spicier than their fresh counterpart, but they're going to be more flavorful and smoky and a little bit sweet.
Sure, absolutely.
What's next, Chef?
So a little bit of citrus. So we're just gonna stir it up a little bit to get them coated.
Yeah, you wanna make sure they're coated. While the sauce is simmering, we throw habanero peppers onto the grill. Once charred, we toss them into our sauce.
So just touches them, it doesn't care.
Go ahead and stir it up.
So what do we do now?
So we have to add the...
We have to add?
The last little bit of heat. Some more habanero, a little bit of chili extract from the skin, all from the habanero.
So this is a concentrate, adding more heat to the already natural heat of all the dry and the fresh. We suit up. What do I do with my eyes?
Don't look in it.
Whoa! Blend the hell sauce. And smother the wings in pure fire. Hottest wings in baseball, you're out of here.
Okay, Casey, are you ready to take on the hottest wings in baseball?
Yes, yes, right. Chef, I'm ready.
So let's bring out the food. You have 6 minutes. You have to eat all 8 wings, everything on the plate, the 2 roasted habaneros, the parsley. You have nothing to drink, no napkins. You finish them all, and this is your lovely prize.
I gotta win this thing.
Are you ready?
I'm ready, let's get a catch.
Okay, you got 6 minutes.
3, 2, 1.
My strategy is to start with the drumsticks because they're thicker and will take more time to eat, so I'm gonna knock them out first. The ghost chili, habanero, and the extract is the ultimate triple play of blazing heat, and it tears through me instantly. With the timer at my back, I'm racing through these wings. But they're literally too hot to handle. I get the okay from the chef.
You're 3 minutes in, you have 3 minutes left. You're halfway, good pace.
And power on. I'm taking down wings 5 and 6 in a back-to-back double play.
Go,
Jason! These wings are major league hot, but my game is strong.
He's in a lot of pain right now. Those are like super hot. He's sweating bad.
Beat the heat! Beat the heat! Beat the heat!
He better pick up the pace, though. The clock is ticking. I really hope he can finish.
Go!
I'm in the 7th inning stretch, and I hit it. The heat wall. The spiciness is so intense, it's slowing my chewing, and I'm trying my hardest to speed it up. With one wing left, I've got home plate in my sights. I'm going for one final push to get the win.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
You weren't kidding, these were super hot. They hit the heat wall. They just couldn't get them down as quickly as I wanted to.
Congratulations on 7.
I did 7!
7 is more than most people could ever imagine doing, so it was a good run.
Thanks, Chef. In a battle of man versus food, unfortunately, food won. But thank you, Phoenix. Woo!